Welcome WBP stars. I'm Chef Vanderbeeken from Apéritif in Ubud, Bali. Today I'm going to prepare a ceviche for you, but my style. So you're going to have three influences from three different countries in one plate. And this is how I think. I'm very open-minded and I really want to be not limited by my cooking. So I really want to experience as much as possible. Yesterday we went to the fish market and then we bought some fish, and here I have a parrot fish, and this one I'm gonna start now with cleaning, and I'm gonna do this in the back so it's not everywhere full of skin. It's a local fish, it's caught with a short line, so it's living in the coral reef. Okay. They are very important for the coral, so we cannot overfish them, so we respect this, so normally we don't really make a lot of publicity. And also from the fish, we're gonna use everything. So it's a zero waste dish. From the skin, we use chips, so we make a crispy fish cake. With the trimmings, we make leche de tigre and tartar to serve to the guests. Washing the fish so it's clean. Also, we use, of course, the bones for the fish stock. So, from the whole fish, we use everything. That's one of the policies I have. Use as much as possible from one ingredient, so you don't have a lot of wastage. You will see with the next dish we're gonna prepare as a crab. Same thing, I use everything from the crab in one dish. Okay. Now we're gonna clean the fish. I always work from head to tail. First, this one off. Always make sure that your knife is sharp, and then you let it slide as close as possible to the bone without making carvings in the meat. Pull your knife down. and we're gonna clean up them. With the spoon later, we take all the meat from the fish to use for tartare or for the leche. So we're gonna spoon all the meat. Now, same with the other side. Have a little bit of skin on the fish, but it's okay, it doesn't harm. Actually with the spoon. Just put all the meat off and we're gonna use it for our leche de tigre. And then the bones we're gonna use for the fumet. So that's for later. Let's continue with the fish filet. We're gonna do one filet. I'm gonna put this on the side. Bones we don't use, so we can cut off. Also use, so we're gonna cook the skin, boil the skin first, then we're gonna clean everything off. Then first then we put the fish in ice water. Clean it. Make it very clean. The other fish as well. So first we put it in ice water to clean it, to make it fresh. And then we dry it a little bit on a towel, and after drying we cure it with non-iodine salt, so pure salt from the ocean. So nothing is, it's directly from the farm, the salt, nothing happened with it, so it's very pure. And we cure it for like 10 minutes. Every day, every morning, fish arrives. First job, clean up the fish, cure it. So when we start, or when the team starts in the afternoon, we just have to pick it and make a roll. So yeah, I'm gonna take this towel, it's a clean towel. To dry a little bit the fish. It's very important to keep everything clean. It's one of the things that I always tell the team. When you do something, when you finish, clean. Otherwise you cannot go ahead. No. This is the pure salt, no iodine salt, so straight from the farmer. It's from near Lovina, so Sinaraja, this area. When we visit the farm, the salt farm, he was also aging the salt. I never heard about this, but 7 years old salt, especially for Korea, must be. Also, they make pyramid salt. Now we're gonna cure the fish, and then we're gonna cut it and making rolls with the roasted nori and wakame. So after the curing, the fish will be more firm, it will be a little bit more drier, but it texture and the flavor of the fish is 100%. Since I know this technique, I learned it from a chef that came here on a visit. And I almost use it for every preparation of fish that I do, because I think it's much better for the fish and also it's very clean. It's a really nice technique. You can, even if you poach your fish after the you see it or whatever. So this I'm gonna put in the jerk and then I'm gonna make it all and the lychee. Ice water again, and we're gonna dry a little bit the fish. It's really nice because we have here a very, very good sea salt. So it's like I said, in the north of Bali. We visit the guy, Newman is his name. He's selling his product in Indonesia, but the raw salt, actually, the pure salt. He didn't really sell, but we were asking for it, and so he's making a business of it. It's good for him, it's good for us. Everybody happy. You can see the fish are already like more firm. This I'm gonna turn in a cheese towel. The fish I'm gonna put in a cheese towel. The fish I'm gonna put in a cheese towel. And then I leave it for 24 hours in the chiller. So tomorrow, when it's completely dried and clean, then we're gonna make rolls. And of course, you cannot wait 24 hours. So I made already one for you. So we roast wakame and we roast nori seaweed in the oven for 160 degrees. Then we slice the fish in small pieces. Like you can see, pieces like this. Those are all small pieces fish, this size, average. And then each piece, we put in the nori powder, and then we roll it together in the plastic, and then we keep it like for 4 hours. And the seaweed, the nori and the wakame is a little bit of like gelatin when it becomes wet, so the powder, so it sticks together to the fish. And like I said, we use everything from the fish, so I need the filling of the fish for making the lychee. Filling of the fish. The filling of the fish. Okay, I took some trimming of the fish, so we're gonna make now the lychee de tigre. So start with the fish. This is a Mexican recipe, so my sous chef before, he's still from Mexico, but I had a Mexican sous chef. And when I was there on a fish chef collaboration a few years ago, I went to the fish market, and that's where I learned how to make this lychee, and then he gave me the exact recipe, what was all inside. Because in Mexico, when you go to the market, the fish market, actually they just mix their fish with lemon. That's what I saw, the citrus. And then actually they just squeeze the leftover trimmings of the fish all together. And that's their leche. Now what is so special on our dish, like I said, it's a ceviche, but it's not 100% ceviche. So also again, my experience and my travels, they brought me to the Philippines. And the Philippines, first time I ate there, kinilaw. And kinilaw is calamansi mixed with coconut milk. And then with fish, it's like a ceviche, but with coconut milk and calamansi. So we have three really important techniques here in this dish, and that's the fish himself, the curing, and then with the wakame and the nori. Then we have the leche de tigre from Mexico. Then we have the homemade coconut milk that we mix with the leche de tigre. So it's almost like kinilaw. So a lot of citrus. You always can add a little bit extra after. Then we add some chili. If you really want it spicy, then you can add more chili. But we always think about the European standard for spiciness because we have a lot of European guests. Put some galangal. Some celery. Of course, this leche is not 100% the leche you're gonna find on the internet or in a cookbook. This is our version. We always try to make something unique or different based on what we ate or what we experience. And from this point, then we move on. Now we put it in a cheese towel. Like I said, in Mexico, they put the fish with the citrus, the leftovers, the trimmings, like the mousse, put everything together, they put it in a towel, and they squeeze until all the jus, all the fish is out. That's the leche de tigre. Tiger milk. The story says that if you eat this, you become as strong like a tiger. We're gonna leave this dripping. Clean up again. lychee we're going to mix together with the coconut milk. So if I have the lychee, I will mix it together. And then like I explained to you the fish, like all small pieces, and then with the roasted nori and wakame around, make a nice roll. And I'm gonna take a plate, and I'm gonna have salsa. What we're doing is we make a Mexican salsa. So it's corn, tomato, shallot, and corn you find here everywhere. If you go to the beach, you have corn with chili. I have here already one piece that I cut. So you can think it's like sashimi or sushi. Put this on the Mexican salsa. We made also an avocado emulsion. More thick, we have chili. And then we have hiyiki seaweed, so we go back to Japan. So we have Mexico, Japan, and then later we're gonna have the Philippines on the plate. And of course a little bit of the of meat. Because that's how we cook. We make food from all our experience all over the world. So we don't restrict ourselves to cook French or Japanese or Indonesian. It's food without borders and quality. Very important. The hiyiki is marinated. Instead of in the Philippines, they combine the fresh coconut milk with the calamansi, we do it with leche de tigre. So we bring Mexico to the Philippines. And then of course, put it in the plate. Why I don't put it on top? Because the guest can taste first like the sashimi, like from Japan. And then he can mix everything together with the lychee, so he's eating like sashimi and ceviche together. cosmos flowers in green. As you can see, there is a lot of detail in each dish. There is a lot of flavor, a few techniques. But you have to be very open-minded. And then we add some leek oil. Kaffir lime oil, no leek oil. To make it more fresh. And also the oil gives the body more to the leche de tigre, so it's more body with the oil. And this is the leche, the tigre, that's the ceviche.